send him my Instagram and math to QL for his students period of 1-2. This is my homework completion chart. I didn't fill out my homework because I didn't really fully understand it. And if I like really didn't understand it, I didn't like truly did. Because like I barely had anything on there. And like I tried to ask like my family members for help or ask like questions, but it really didn't fill it, so it was kind of surprising to me. Like I kind of like did really good on my notebook check and my homework, so I don't know. This is my assessment score chart. I completed some of my corrections, not all of them though. I got up with my teacher and my friends by asking, like, comparing answers. And went to the, and by myself, I went to the problems to get. So, I don't know, I still didn't understand them. What I did this semester, I went to office hours every time I was confused or not sure how to do my homework. Another thing I did was, like, I raised my grade, and, like, by, like, diving, I try to check answers with my friends. So I didn't start checking the DP because I rarely check the DP. I would always forget what homework was, and I always forget the DP names. This is my quiz number 2, congruent triangles. My misunderstanding was thinking forgot to put what kind of triangle it was. I just put how many congruent sides it has, and I forgot to put the name. It was not, and my mistake was not justifying the answer. This is one of my test problems. The question was find each number angle and justify your answer. My misunderstanding was doing some other type of problem with it. So I was getting really confused because I was trying to do this other concept. So I kind of got like a lot of them wrong. Quiz and test comparison, they're like from the same unit because they were just different quiz and tests, but like I think I got around the same grade on both of them, which is like a C minus, I think. I'm not sure. I think the grade I deserve is probably like a C plus because I try hard, but I still don't do some of my homework because I get distracted a lot in my house. The grade I have right now is C minus. It kind of does reflect my knowledge and my understanding of the units. This is quasi my chemistry POF. Doing is unit 2.8, atomic structure and nuclear chemistry. Students will be able to explain how the nucleus of the atom is much smaller than the atom with the 3 points of atomics. The reason for that is because, say like this is the atom here, this is all the proton electrons, so you got the electrons in the outer rim. The center of it holds most of its mass because it has more, because there's a lot of protons and neutrons inside of it, which make it more of its mass. Experiment based for Thomas's discovery of the electron, which was like he had this little tube right here. He shot a stream of electrons currents like through this right here, this line, through a thin sheet of foil. Most of them went to a positive charge and they repelled negative. So he knew like the electrons were like negative. Like that's how he discovered the electrons. They repelled the positive charge. Repelled the negative went to the positive. And the second one is the Rutherford's nuclear momentum, which is right here. He fired a stream of alpha particles through a thin sheet of gold foil, as presented right here. 90% of them went through, which is this part, and then 1%, which is the ones that are out here, they weren't detected. They're seeing like it has atom has like mostly space. Like has most space in it, and the center is really dense, so it's just a nucleus. It's really dense. My next one is explain how protons and neutrons in the nucleus are held together by the nucleus forces that overcome this one, like, I didn't really do good, but it's, I think it's like the reason they're all held together here is because the electrons are on the outer rim, holding with, like, with their force, holding the, they have a force holding, pushing them together like this. Next one is explain how some natural occurring isotopes of elements are radioactive and are some formed in the nuclear. Isotopes are the same thing as they're like, you know, what, like atoms, but like they have a different mass to them, which make them isotopes and make them radioactive. The next one, the next learning target is explaining the three most common forms of radioactive decay with alpha, beta, and gamma, and know how nucleus changes at each time. It kind of changes because, you know, one's positive, one's neutral, one's negative, and then they have different things like this one here has paper, this has lead and concrete, this has cardboard and foil, which make them like all different forms. Stop. And that's my presentation. Thank you for listening.
Thank you.